verse 9 to 31.
Acts chapter 3 verse 19, it talks about restoration. Are your Bibles open? Okay, you read alongside with me. What's the first word there? Repent ye therefore and be converted, so that your sins may be blotted out. Until times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. And he shall send Jesus Christ. Let me read the verse. So you can open that. Acts 3, 19 to 21. And he shall send Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you. So this is Jesus Christ. When Peter talked about sending Jesus Christ, is that the first coming or second coming?
Second coming.
No, it's the second coming, which was preached, already preached. So if Jesus Christ was already preached, he already died, he was buried and resurrected already. So when Peter talked about sending Jesus Christ, it's the second coming. So you can imagine, if this is the church ages, there are seven church ages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it's the seventh. He shall send Jesus Christ. How is he going to send? He's going to send it back to earth again. What's the next verse? Whom heaven must receive. Mark it down in your Bible. Whom heaven must receive. So he is up there in heaven, our mediator. Whom heaven must receive until. So there is a time period. This is the period of until. The times of restitution of all things. So, whom heaven must receive until. So until that time, there is a restoration, he will come back again. And what is supposed to be restored? Verse 22, all things. Whatsoever things he said to you is the word of God. It's revelation. Of course, there are some commentators that say this is about Israel. I'm not against that. You can apply it to the time of Adamic restoration. Because after that, it's the millennium and the eternal age. So, but let's talk about restoration within the church age. There is an apostasy in the church age, and there is a restoration in the church age. And we have to follow on through that restoration so that we can get what this is the seventh seal, what is the exact master key so that you will receive the Holy Ghost. You will follow on through God's progressive revelation. You know what God is doing at the present truth. Not just the past, not just the future, but you know what He's going to do, the present truth. In every age, He has a master key. In every age, He builds His house on the rock. And how is that house being built? How do you apply Acts 2:38 repentance in our lives? That's what I add that term, the rare repentance. That's how you manifest with the word. I'm going to show you the Nicolaitan spirit also that's plaguing all churches today. This Nicolaitan spirit that's plaguing all churches today, these are schisms, these are close-mindedness, these are partisanships. These are judgmental spirits. These are prejudices. And there are many, shall we say, dogmatic teachings that was inherited from the denominations. Teachings of men, still. We have Babylonian garments we have to cast away. Okay, let's go back here. So Jesus Christ is in heaven, mediating for us, which before was preached unto you. Whom heaven must receive, and he will send Jesus Christ. Now, what is this restitution? So let me enumerate what I mentioned a while ago. You can take note. The restitution is number one. Some have applied it to Israel. Some have applied it to Adamic restoration after the, even before the fall. But what we're going to talk about is church age, restoration within the church. In lieu of this, that could connect all these three, we could use the promise given in 70 weeks of Daniel. Maybe we could take a peek. Let's open up. Daniel chapter 9, verse 24. Let's open up. There are sixfold purposes mentioned there. The sixfold purposes mentioned there, it seems like it's about Israel. But if you understand carefully, it does not only involve Israel, it involves the church. Not only involves the church, it involves the whole world. So all these things will be involved. So please open up, please read for us. Daniel chapter 9, verse 24. Who can read for us? 7 weeks are given unto you. Daniel is in the middle, before Hosea, after Hosea. Okay, sister, Eric. Who has the Bible?
English. 77 are decreed for your people and your holy city to finish transgression, to put an end of to sin, to atone for wickedness, to bring in everlasting righteousness, to seal up visions and prophecy, and to anoint the most holy.
Now understand little by little. It's about the city. It's about Israel. But later he talks about finish the transgression. He talks about make reconciliation for iniquity, make an end for sins, to anoint the most holy, to seal up the vision of prophecy. Now, when you talk about, when Daniel was reading this, he was being answered with regards to Israel. To make an end of sins, to finish the transgression. And literally did he realize, it's not just Israel's transgression that will be ended. It will be the whole world. And before it will be ushered in, the church will come in. Jesus Christ will come in, the church will come in. And the church and Israel will go parallel side by side, up to the end. There is what we call the last week of Daniel here. 7-year tribulation period. The last week of Daniel. First Timothy chapter 4 verse 1. The Spirit speaketh expressly in the last days. That in the last days.
The Spirit clearly says that in a later time some will abandon the faith and follow deceiving spirits and think that taught by demons.
So this is almost 1,000 years of apostasy. And I will illustrate with a darkened black box. To illustrate the apostasy, the corruption aspect of the church. It started with the Godhead apostasy. Let me write it down. The beginning of the Trinitarian doctrine. Then, the change in the formula for baptism. And the rest is history. After this, they still allow pastors or priests to marry. Several hundred years later, they would make it compulsory to be celibate. Okay? So there are many other doctrines that came around later. Purgatory, indulgence, and many other things. Relics, worship of relics. Now let's go to the restoration. The restoration prophesied by Peter, the mouth of Peter. Let's go to 1500s. Never realized the Protestants were used. And let me add some tidbit. This is almost 2,000 years. If this is 1500, what is the fraction? What almost not fun. This is what we call the fourth watch. The group that calls themselves the fourth watch, they has this kind of explanation that we are in the fourth quarter. But in this fourth quarter, this is where the Reformation started. In creation, it's almost the same. Nearing the time of man, creation of man, creation becomes more complicated. Here, the main focus in the restoration is in the fourth quarter, starting from the 1500s, fourth watch. Okay. Here, we call this the Protestants. Under Martin Luther, let me write Luther's name. What, he had a restoration of a previous revelation by the apostles that was muddled up in the Dark Ages. What is that revelation? Brother Vermin? Brother Chris? What is the revelation of Martin Luther that was muddled up?
Justification.
The just shall live by faith. So you have the evangelicals today, they still insist on faith, accepting Jesus Christ as a personal savior. They just keep going back on that truth that was revealed hundreds of years ago. It's a truth that was really revealed by God to a messenger.
That's right.
But the Word of God walks on. The progressive revelation goes on. We have to follow the light. Walk in the light. Do not just stand there as what the Sadducees and the Pharisees were. They got protected to what they know. Walk in the light. So, alongside Luther, his contemporaries, there was Calvin. What revelation of John Calvin? Brother Chris?
Calvin,
yes, predestination. But I'm gonna leave it reserving to someone else. What other revelation of John Calvin? It's what they call eternal security. Just the right explanation of this, there's a wrong explanation of this. But it's not yet our time to talk about how it will be balanced. That's what they call the Baptist called conditional eternal security and unconditional eternal security. And alongside that, the cousin of that revelation is predestination. I left it with John Dunst, but these two are related. These are Presbyterian churches. Baptist churches. Some Baptists would not want to be associated with them. But the Baptists today are still free charges. That is, they came out from this revival. They were given freedom from this revival. Even though some of them were really persecuted. That's the 1500s, their contemporaries. There's another under the category of Protestants, but it's in another age. It's in the Bible what we call the Philadelphian church age, the age of the open door. In the seven parables of Matthew chapters 13, just write this down. So I think just study it more. Matthew chapter 13 has seven parables, almost eight, but the eight is talks about perfection. Okay? In the sixth parable, a pearl of great price, the fifth parable is a merchant man that has a treasure field. It had something to do with restoration. In the fourth parable, it's the Dark Ages, a woman putting linen and three measures of milk. In the third church age, it's Constantine. The small seed becoming a large tree, and fowls of the air make their home in the tree. So, here in 1800s, it's the time of John Wesley. What is the revelation of John Wesley?
Sanctification.
This means setting apart, becoming holy. Be holy, for I'm holy. The revelation that carried over to the Pentecostals was from the Methodists. These are from the Evangelical churches, Presbyterian churches, Baptist churches, but here is what we have, Methodist churches. Those truths will be carried over to another age of time, in the 1900s. This era of the Protestants, there is a restoration. So you can see with my restoration of the box, it became the light. Some of the light was restored. See? Now before you continue, what is salvation? You know, I've been to Sister Amy's house. I've shared this. And some of which are the true one. But even the 7 Adventists, if I share this, which is the truth? You do not look upon the truth of God as some box in the frozen in time that you can just receive. The same error that's taking place in the entire message today. They want to box the revelation of the prophet. What was revealed to the prophet is enough. The same in the attitude of the denominations. What was revealed to Luther was enough. What was revealed to Calvin was enough. What was revealed to the Pentecostal was enough. So take note, we are all in the process of restoration. We are going back to the original. So we have to keep an open mind. We have to have Berean repentance. If we truly have repentance of Acts 2:38, it's not just a repentance of vices or crimes or wicked works. It's a repentance from ignorance. It's a repentance from being closed-minded. From the will of God. Knowing the will of God. That's the right way of knowing the will of God. Okay, here in the 1900s, it's the time of the Pentecostals. There is a restoration of the revelation about who were degraded by the Brahman.